After a hard day's work. If your timing is as rotten as your luck, I understand why you've come to see me. No, it's fine. Please take a seat. I will leave the leaf for later. I finish every day with leaf and kimchi. The leaf I will forego for just now. The kimchi I invite you to try. Kimchi is a potion, or rather, solution I brew myself. I suppose it's closest to what you would call fire water. I will pour you a glass. It's drunk in the same way you would drink your fire water. It's shot to the back of the throat and swallowed. Be mindful, while it is not alcoholic, it is not to be taken lightly. No, I am in no rush. Sure enough, I thought I'd locked the door, but you are here now. Cheers. Delightful, isn't it? Leaves one with a warm and comforted feeling. Oh, kimchi is very old, old process of distillation. I learned it in my time in the far, far east. I was there for many years. Has quite a unique taste to it. Goes perfect with a little leaf. Now, what can I do you for? Yes. Potion of luck. I think I can help you. Oh, there's more. Elixir of fortune. That's a little harder to do, but I have the ingredients, if you have the coin, of course. Good. The luck potion. 3 gold. And 22 silver. Fine. Now the fortune. Let me just check my stock. We have the Sicilian. We have the dart. Be mindful. Potion of fortune can be intensified. Every additional 10 coins, I will throw in another 2 leaves. Understand? Each leaf increases its potency. Good. Fine. It won't take me but a minute to whip them up. Sit tight and enjoy the sensation of the kimchi. Now. Oh, I've been here a very, very long time. What makes me so much more effective than every other potion maker, alchemist, apothecary, witch, is I use only the finest ingredient. We'll start with the potion of luck. comes from a cave far, far away. 18 months. Be very, very careful. This is herb called octane. Octane is only found in one known place in all our world. Although rare and very expensive, it has no trouble growing in this particular cave. People have tried to recreate the environment and location of it. A little more, I think. I tried to cultivate it myself for many years, but it just will not seem to grow. A touch more. It takes 3/4 of a gram to achieve the desired results. A strand more. There. See the difference in ingredient that I use? Not only is it the finest, but you will never see me touch a leaf, a strand, or a root. I see these apothecaries manhandling their herbs. Fools. All of them fools. The human hand. Is covered in oils, dirt. And every time you will lose some of the effectiveness of the plant. It's very important never to touch, as I'm sure your parents told you. Now, along with 1 gram, we also add 1 cup of diamond distilled water. Now the process again of distillation with diamond water. We take running river water. It must be flowing. And it's dripped into a hollow diamond. Now, diamond, as you know, comes at great cost. Great cost. It is left to ferment in the diamond for 40 days and 41 nights. And on the 41st night, the water is extracted and fed through a blue amethyst. It's allowed to circulate for 1 day. It must be stirred and cared for inside this amethyst. And at the end of the day, the water is so pure and so clear that it is the perfect base for any potion. Like always, it comes at a great cost. Now, once we've added the herb, we add the second. This is cane leaf. Now, cane leaf, surprisingly, actually grows in my back garden. And it will only take 2 strands of cane leaf. It is a grass that for some reason flourishes in our part of the world. Perfect. Now, the cane leaf acts as a catalyst. Once we add this little ingredient, this is a powder, and it comes from the fade leaf. Now, the fade leaf is a very small plant that grows off the North Continent. Inside the fade leaf are tiny seeds. These seeds are ground down to produce fade leaf powder. Now, one vial. Fade leaf powder. Reacts with the cane leaf, which is our catalyst. Then we grind through the solution. And the reason we add the diamond distilled water before we grind. Because the liquid within the cane leaf doesn't mix as well in its purest form. So when ground, it's released slowly into the water. The solution is a milky color until we add our final ingredient. Yes. Good. 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 Perfect. Now, luck is an interesting thing. It is perhaps my most requested potion. But what people don't understand with luck, the universe has already decided what is for you and what is not for you. However, luck acts as a variable, an intangible, if you like, something that cannot be accounted for because it has an element of random. What the potion does is it increases the frequency of this randomness. It produces far higher levels of luck than you could ever hope to achieve. Now, that's not what I want. Is what I need. This is blood of the spear. Blood of the spear. Good. Another drop. Good. Blood of the spear. Isn't it actually blood at all? Don't be alarmed. It's squeezed and extracted from a rock, of all things. From Spear Point. Spear Point is, 30 days' travel to the far west. sits atop a giant, giant, monstrous mountain. Spear Point has been a place of worship for a very long time. Yes, that smells perfect. Unfortunately, Potion of Luck is not the most attractive. However, it has been known to be extraordinarily effective. You will have one potion of luck. Be very mindful. This must be consumed in one drink. You can mix it with beer, water, it doesn't matter. What matters is that every drop is drunk. Perfect. Good. Now, I will pop your lid. One potion of luck. Good. Now, I will change over my pestle and mortar. Okay, now, the fame and fortune potion. Well, you asked for fortune, but as an advisory, fame will always follow fortune. No, there is... how best to say, a level of risk when messing with somebody's fortune and their level of fame. Be very mindful in what you are asking for. Yes? The potion itself is 50 gold, and as mentioned, for every additional leaf we add, it's another 10 gold. It can go infinitely. To quantify it into how much each leaf will gain you is difficult, if not impossible, to do. I sold a man a potion for 60 gold once. And he became the wealthiest man in his country. I sold another man an 80 gold potion. And he became only the wealthiest in his family. As with the luck potion, the universe has already decided for you what amount. What we are doing is bending the rules. Bending it to the point of breaking. Now. I always have some reservations. Not everybody ends happily with more money. Let that be a lesson to you. But it is what you ask for, and it is what I will provide. 100 gold, fortune and fame potion. Sicilian root. I'll need to send my squire for more. Sicilian root is purchased from a little island. Not too far from here. 6 months on a boat, another month by horseback. This is so expensive because it's controlled by the warrior tribe on the island. It actually grows quite plentifully. And each sprig contains 3 leaves. The base of your luck potion was a little different. It's measured in grams. This is measured in sprigs. That's the remaining 4, taking you from your 6 to your 100 gold. I warn you again, money does not bring everyone happiness. The compliment is a little herb you can find in almost any garden. It's called dilly, and you only need the smallest pinch. This does. It acts as a binding agent. This time, however, we grind without solution. These leaves, again, are the perfect complement. I spent many years perfecting and concentrating my fortune potion. It has a very distinct smell, the dilly. It's not too dissimilar to cotton, that fresh cotton smell. Sadly, what we have to add is not quite so sweet. A little less than a cup this time of the diamond distillation water. This little vial, oddly enough, is something called Kinefort. Now, Kinefort is a type of heather. Heather being very old plant. It grows the very northern reaches, where it's cold. The plant, for some reason, seems to thrive in cold weather. It has a pinky purple tinge to its leaves. And when ground down, they emit a white powder, not unlike the seed. This little vial here would set you back the cost of your house. Essence of Arkin is black like the heart of a necromancer. It's very, very potent and must be dealt with very carefully. Good. It has a foul, foul smell. Actually, a large serpent lives in the bog of Kerathor. The Arkin got a plague on the land and are hunted. However, their bones can be ground. And their blood is boiled down to an essence of Arkin. It smells quite distinct. However, the smell of a fortune and fame potion is unlike no other. If success had a smell, my friend, this would be it. $100. Think of it as an investment, my friend. For that's exactly what it is. Now, to finish, I need a lock of your hair. Reacts to only specific person. It's a distillation. If I was to add my hair to the potion, nothing would work. While you were completely unaware, during the grounding of the herbs, I have to imagine and picture you fortuitously. It channels something I cannot even explain into the potion. But with years of experience, I tell you for sure, without that concentration, without the hair follicle, it will not bind. Perhaps it's the Arkin essence, specific to each person's soul, they say. Now, potion of luck and one potion of fortune. The luck potion has a red tinge to it. Do not confuse them. The potion of fortune and fame, well, it's dark. Both must be consumed as one, meaning you can drink each separately. But as with the potion of luck, they must be consumed in one. You cannot drink them in stages, regardless of the flavor and the taste. Now, the matter of my payment. Thank you. I can still see the glaze to your eyes. Kimchi is not to be underestimated, my friend. Please, let me know how you get on. I do like to hear how well and how happy my potions make people. You have a very strong concoction between the luck and the fortune and fame. As with my herbs, those two complement each other quite well. Some people can get rich, but they are not lucky enough to hold on to it. The luck potion can add as a buffer. If I may, I suggest holding on to the luck potion until after this newfound wealth comes to you. That way it acts as a method of retaining the luck and the money. Do be careful. And I'll see you again soon. Please, be happy and enjoy life. Savor every moment and experience, including the